Bonjour, hi! Welcome in another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Let me introduce myself. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP, based in Montreal in Canada. Today, we continue to talk about the Azure Devtest Lab, and I will show you how to create custom artifacts. You'll see, it's not that complicated. This is the third video about Devtest Lab. To see the previous one, I will put the link in the description. A lot of time when we use the Devtest Lab, it's to test our own private code that we are working on. So we don't want that sitting on GitHub. It's probably in VSTS or in a private repository. So that's why today I want to create a custom artifact. That question came from Damien, so thanks Damien for your questions. You want to know how to create a custom artifact that will, for in this case, change the time zone. So that's exactly what we will do. One of the frequent questions I have is, how do you know all those templates and how can I know them? Well, to get started, it's easy with Azure. It's right in the portal. So if you go in the portal, this is my Devtest Lab. The second one in the options is getting started. If you click on that, you will have a lot of URL very useful. And if you look down there, here I see sample artifacts and script. You click on that, it will open the GitHub repository where all examples are displayed. And if I scroll, I could see that I have a folder named artifacts. I will click on it. And that's all the artifacts. They are all listed there. So because I want to execute a PowerShell command, I will have a look to something PowerShell related. So if I look, I have here Windows run PowerShell. That looked pretty close to what I want to do. In that specific folder, you will always find a file named artifactfile.json. This is really important and you cannot change that name. So let's have a look to this file. So it looked like a simple JSON file with a title, a description, a publisher, some tags, very useful, then the icon URL. You will see parameters. I will show you later where parameters showed. And then you got your execution. Okay, so I think we know enough to create our own. So first, we need a private repository. You could use any kind of Git repository. I will use one in VSTS. So I'm in VSTS and I will create a new project. I will call it Cloud 5 Minutes Artifacts. And like you could see here, it's private. Okay, the project is created. Now I just want, usually you will have cloned the environment on your machine, build your code from there, pushed, and it will work. Because it's a demo, I will work directly in VSTS since it includes a code editor. So I will need to initialize my repository. So now I need a main folder. I will name it artifacts. Voila. And because in Git a folder cannot be empty, I need to create a file. So we'll just put a README file for now. The README file will be empty and I'm committing. Perfect. So now I have my root and I don't know how to spell README apparently. So I need to create another folder because every artifact needs to be enclosed in his own specific folder. So I need to create a new one. So another folder. My artifact is only Windows based. So it's a best practices if your artifact is only working on a specific platform to name it with it. So Windows set time zone will be the name of my folder for my artifact. So like we saw, an artifact is always declared inside the artifactfile.json. So we'll create that. So I took the liberty here to take the JSON file that we saw previously and just clean it. So here we see that I have a title. I'm just putting a description that makes sense. publisher is my name. You could put the company name or whatever you want. And then the icon URL, it will be interesting in the list to put something personal. This icon need to be sitting in a public zone. So it could be on GitHub, it could be a blob storage, it could be a website. Here, I just use an existing one in the Git repository. And then I have my command. So for my specific case, I will be using the, I will be executing the command tzutil to set the time zone. And because I'm Eastern Standard Time, I will just set it to that. I could have passed a parameter and then set the parameter here, but I want to keep it as simple as possible. If you set a parameter, I will show you later where that parameter will appear. Perfect. So now let's commit. Great. So now we are on the master branch. The root folder is named artifacts. And we have one artifact called Windows Set Time Zone. Great. So now we need to use that repository inside our DevTest lab. We need to make the connection. So to do that, we'll go in the Azure portal. So we'll go back in our Azure portal and we'll go in configuration and policies. So here in the left panel, you will see repositories. So click on that. And here we have the only one right now is the public one. So we'll add a new one. So now we need to give it a name. So let's call it Frank Repo. Frank Repo. So now we need the URL of our Git repo. I will show you in VSTS, but of course it may differ if you were using something else. But most of the time you will see a clone button in your repository. So you click on that. And that will give you your URL. So you will use this. Remember, I was in the master branch. Of course, if you're using another branch that is QA or dev, you will use that name here. To access the repository, since it's private, you will need to use a personal access token. To get this token in VSTS, you will need to go in your profile security and generate an access token. Then we need to specify the root of our artifact. So in our case, it was artifacts. So voila, so we're good to go. Save. Excellent. So now we have our repository that is accessible from our DevTest lab. Let's create a formula that uses this repository. Of course, we could create a VM directly, but since I show in the previous video how useful were the formula, I will continue with those. So let's go back at the lab level and I will list the formulas. So I will create a new formula and I will create a Visual Studio machine. So let's say, yeah, that one. We'll name it DevBox, username Frank, SSD, we'll give more CPU so it's faster. And the moment of truth, the artifact list. So here we have our artifact. Set time zone, execute the tzutil command. Publisher Frank Boucher. So exactly what was specified in the JSON file. If I had parameters, they will be listed here. So perfect. So click on add and that's it. For now, we'll just put that since it's the only thing I want to use. Great. So now we have our formula. Okay. So let's recap. We have our repository of artifacts. Inside, we declare a one artifact. We connected that artifact list to our DevTest lab, created one formula using that artifact. And of course, the only thing left now is just create a VM using that formula. So to do this, we'll go in all virtual machine, we'll create add, voila. So I will use my formula. So it should be all populated. Excellent. And I just need to create it. Voila. I will cut it there and I will see you when the VM is created. So the VM is now created. So let's have a look inside and see if our artifact works. Yes, so many pop-ups. So the time for Easter time is 8:22. So if I check in Bing, it's 8:22. It works. That's great. Now you know how to do it in the portal. In the previous episode, I showed you how to create using the ARM template. So how could you do that? To know what kind of resources a repository is, we need to go in the Resource Explorer. And then you will, from the Resource Explorer, find again your resource group, and then your lab, and then you will find artifact sources. And here it is, our Cloud 5 Minutes repository we created. So the type is artifact sources. We can even go on the Microsoft documentation and we'll see here the documentation. So this artifact sources, you will need to inject it in your ARM template at the second resource list. So if you remember, an ARM template is a big JSON file and you will have a first node called resourced. Inside that one, you will have one that is a dev test lab. And inside that dev test lab, you will have a second node named resources. It's in that node that you will add your artifact sources at the same level where the network, virtual network was. And of course, to use our artifact in your formula, you just need to refer as it was done previously with the public one, but this time you will refer the private one. Voila! It was that easy to create a custom artifact in a dev test lab. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. Don't hesitate to share and give me a thumbs up if you liked it. And of course, reach out and ask questions. I'm always happy to help you guys. To see all the videos about dev test lab, have a look just here. Or if you want to see another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes, click here. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Yeah.